my name is Brett Kingman. This is the brand new EQuator pedal, an EQ pedal, a four-band active EQ pedal from Brian Wampler, and it is definitely one of the most well-considered and thought-out EQ pedals that I've ever come across. Maybe the most well-thought-out and well-considered EQ pedal. Across the top here, four controls. Bass, tuned at 130 Hz, plus or minus 19 dB. Now, 130 Hz is about the flood point of a Marshall quad that's got, say, greenbacks in it. That means that you can tighten up your sound by cutting the bass, or you can add more bottom end if you're a bass player by boosting it. I'm going to skip to the treble control. 7K, again, the other end kind of the frequency spectrum, extreme spectrum of a guitar cabinet. Most guitar speakers you won't hear a lot above 7K. That's really their treble spot. And again, 19 dB plus or minus. I'll just give you a demo of those two. This old MJT T-style running into my Achilles Argos, which is, for all intents and purposes, a JTM45 with lots of mods, but I'm running it like a JTM45. It sounds like this. Classic sound. If I turn on the EQuator at flat, pretty much the same EQ, but buffered, so it's a bit clearer. If I bump 7K up, you start to hear that here. Ditto the bass control. I would probably back it off to tighten things up. If I was playing, say, a 7 or an 8 string, that would be very useful. In between, we've got probably the two most important controls, and they are mids 1 and mids 2 and their respective frequency controls. Now, mids 1 will let you boost or cut the frequency range of its control by about 15 dB. That's, I think, from about 230 Hz up to 5 kHz. That's a fairly wide Q. So we can do this. Get that kind of cocked wah sound, but at the same time we can also, you know, take that out as opposed to, already I've got something approaching, you know, more of an acoustic sound. For instance, mids 2 has a greater frequency boost, 25 dB or minus, but a smaller EQ, so I think it's from about 400 up to 4.5K. So we can do with it this. Of course, once I've fine-tuned those frequencies or found the ones that I want, I can turn them up or down by means of the general volume control, which means I can push the amp harder with those frequencies if I want to. Are you getting all this? Which turns the pedal in effectively into an overdrive control because it's pushing certain frequencies, a bit like a treble booster, into the amplifier. Now I can use both of these middle controls to do that even stronger. Makes a hell of a difference, doesn't it? If I flatten them out again, and I'm trying to go as fast and show you as many different examples as I can here, and it's tough because this pedal is so versatile. Let's say I want more of an acoustic sound out of my neck pickup. So I'm going to just give you that clean tone first. I'm going to turn the volume down and bump up 7K a bit. Already it's cleaned it up a ton. Thank you. that bass is still pretty strong, so I'm going to back it off a little bit. Turn it up. As opposed to... They're just two things that I can do with it, with a guitar and a standard amplifier. Now, you can use it with bass, you could use it with vocals, you could put it anywhere between your anywhere in the signal path and anywhere on your pedal board to preempt, say, an overdrive or come after an overdrive to do something. For instance, like this. Here's the hot wire, which is coming before the equator, and it sounds like this. So I can use the 7K to smooth it out a bit, or I can push the mids a little bit more just by bumping them up. And use the volume control as a second gain stage for the amplifier. It's a lot to take in, isn't it? So I'll do that again with the neck pickup. The hot wire. And the equator. Hot wired off. Equator off. All the sweet spots for the mid controls are clearly marked. They will get you started at the kind of singing mids points that Brian has correctly labelled. You can run it between 9 and 18 volts. I imagine you'll get more headroom out of 18 volts. I'm running it at 9 today. 130 hertz to 7K, all the mid spots in between with two different cues, volume control, built like a tank, top mounted jacks, made by Brian Wampler in the USA. You just can't go wrong. See you soon. Thanks for watching.